So yesterday, November 16, 2018, RC2 for FreeNAS is available. So a couple changes they made here. Looks a little more polished once again. Some of the plugins are back, but let's dig into a couple details that were fixed here. So this is kind of a change log for it. Fixed some smart problems, a couple middleware event issues. So smart apparently wasn't sending emails for that. Update IOCade section. Update net data 1.8. Now, I do love net data that it's included in here, and there's been a recent change because I think they found some type of security flaw in it. So if you have net data at all, please update it. And the folks at FreeNAS have updated the one they embed with it as well. It's just a great way to look at all the stats and everything on your FreeNAS box or any other server if you run this as a standalone. There's a few other things in here, like an SNMP commits, but one of the ones that really was driving me crazy that they have finally fixed was this. And I'm kind of using this pseudo more or less in production. And the reason why was I want to really test it. So, we've got a handful of things running on it actively and making sure there's no problems. That way I can give you guys a fairly up-to-date status of it. And of course, myself, file any bug reports if I find anything major. But this was a problem that they had before where they limited you to short passwords. And I'm definitely going to call that a bug. They did fix this now in RC2. So if you were playing with RC1 and had that problem, it's a warning that there's compatibility with longer passwords with certain services that rely on the internal database. So if you're not using any service that relies on that internal database that requires a shorter password, you can type a longer one. But before, it just stopped you from doing that, and that was actually quite annoying. So happy to see that fixed. Happy to see some updates on this. And, I've been running RC1 is when I started in production. Now I switched over to RC2. Each of those upgrade paths have gone fine. I've seen a few people complain about Plex problems. Because this is running at my office, I've only done testing with Plex like for some video demos. I haven't tested it again, but honestly, based on the bugs that people have been emailing me about, I've pushed them. I'm like, you got to talk to people in the forums about it. I run Plex as a standalone because sometimes the plugins get out of date, so I'm not the most experienced at that. But of course, you may have some problems running the release candidates and getting some of those things to work. Now, there's still a few issues here in the that are targeted for release. So far, a few bugs, like misspelling the word success. I don't know, something about that one made me laugh. Another one about ACLs, metadata corruption on ZFS send receive. I haven't seen that. I've been using ZFS send receive back and forth between my two FreeNAS servers, the 11.1U6 and the 11.2, and that seems to be working. I also have been moving data back and forth to Helm and just using command line rsync and dumping data. It's not had really any issues, so that's been working well. Nonetheless, my overall has been happy with FreeNAS. Go ahead and download. This is still release candidate. We're at RC2, but if you want to look at the roadmap, we're looking at just 16 more days. We'll have the final release version ready, and that's kind of exciting. So I don't always get excited when there's new versions coming out of software, from FreeNAS or a lot of the Linux stuff I do, because, it's always new enhancements. It's not like when I get those Windows updates and I go, brace for impact, because it's going to be a busy day of phone calls. So that's it. It's out. It's available. Go ahead and grab it. And my experience has been very positive with it. It works great so far, so hopefully it works great for you. Please note, if you're having any problems with it, go in the forums, join the bug test team, help find these bugs and quash them. As simple as that. That's the, this is how open source projects get better. As we do a lot of testing, we find bugs, we report these bugs, and the devs will get them all fixed. So if you're having problems with Plex, jump in there and try as, get the most information you can together so these can get solved. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, go ahead and click the thumbs up. Leave us some feedback below to let us know any details, what you like and didn't like as well, because we love hearing the feedback. Or if you just want to say thanks, leave a comment. If you want to be notified of new videos as they come out, go ahead and hit the subscribe and the bell icon. That lets YouTube know that you're interested in notifications. Hopefully they send them, as we've learned with YouTube. Anyways, if you want to contract us for consulting services, you go ahead and hit launchsystems.com and you can reach out to us for all the projects that we can do and help you. We work with a lot of small businesses, IT companies, even some large companies, and you can farm different work out to us or just hire us as a consultant to help design your network. Also, if you want to help the channel in other ways, we have a Patreon. We have affiliate links. You'll find them in the description. You'll also find recommendations to other affiliate links and things you can sign up for on lawrencesystems.com. Once again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.